Hello, my name is Alex. I'm an Associate Engineering Manager on F1 Manager 2024. And I manage the code team, and I participate a lot in the code in the game, especially on the racing side.
And hello, I'm Carlos. I'm a senior data designer on F1 Manager 24 as well. And yeah, we're here today to talk a bit about the AI updates for F1 Manager 24.
So of course we have added difficulty options last year post-launch as a patch to F1 Manager 2023. You can select from several difficulty options, and you can obviously change difficulty options separate for race management and race sim. During the races, it will determine how they react to the things that are happening during the race, and they will choose exact same options that you player have, so that how much you push in the car, how much you save fuel, when you do a pit stop. This will also mention, it will change how they react to the safety cars and stuff like this. Anything that happens during the race, really, they will also react to the player options as well. If you push, they will try to push as well to catch up with you, to get from DRS range and stuff like that.
Yeah, and obviously those decisions that they make during the races, during the race weekends, will have an impact on the long-term season planning for those teams as well. So the team management side, that's all those decisions are impacting the teams, the AI teams, as well as the players' teams when it comes to leaving the race weekend. So if we think if they push too much on powertrain components, if they've done a lot of pushing during the race to get positions, then that obviously is going to have an impact on how much they wear, and that gets transported to team management. So penalties might come when the season is finishing. Obviously the AI in terms of team management, there's been a lot of work done on it. So decisions like which drivers to hire, how much teams invest in facilities and so on is controlled by difficulty levels as well. So the easier the player chooses to play, then the more leeway they'll have to surpass other teams that perhaps don't invest as much and don't make those decisions as good and as effective as a player. Yeah, so in terms of driver poaching, the player can absolutely counter-offer. The offers and the dilemmas will come through emails. The player will receive one as soon as there is an offer for one of their drivers. That kickstarts the flow of the poaching process. So there will be a back and forth. The driver might be more inclined or less inclined to accept that offer from the rival team. There is also an impact from mentality on this. So if you're managing your driver really well and they're happy where they are, then they're less likely to accept that offer. But if they're not, then obviously the player can try and still renegotiate the contract they have with the current driver and sign them for a few more years and keep everyone happy. So in terms of poaching and what we're introducing for F1 Manager 24, the offers will come mid-season, so the player will receive offers for drivers as they come during the season. As we've seen with Hamilton and Ferrari for 25, that is something we're going to represent in-game. So the offer will come at some point in the season. The player can then have the option to renegotiate if they want to and try and re-sign that driver and make them happy. But there will be a lot of considerations around when those offers happen, how aggressive the other teams, the rival teams, will be with their offers. So again, difficulty options have a big impact on that. So other teams might be more aggressive in terms of trying to poach the best drivers or the most promising drivers as well. This happens for both the player's team and other rival teams as well, other AI teams. So if we say the player is Mercedes, Alpine are trying to poach one of the drivers, that means that the Alpine will potentially be trying to sign one of the Ferrari drivers and just have a full pool of drivers to select from. So this will be constant during the season. The AI teams will then try to sign drivers for the following seasons as well. It's going to be very dynamic.
Yeah, so I've been working quite hard on the car behavior for F1 Manager 2024. We have lots of improvements just to make it look more realistic and closer to the reality. We have made improvements for car smoothness around the track, how it goes around the corners, and also how it's recovering from the incidents. So it will try to recover as fast as possible, of course, if it didn't crash or anything like this. And then you should lose less time when going back into the track. And another thing we added is what we call the squeeze-out behavior. So you'll see way more battling into the corner side by side, And if your car and driver is aggressive, or maybe you told them to be aggressive, they will squeeze out the other car out of a corner, and then you'll see that sometimes you'll be forced out of the track, or maybe you'll force someone else into the track.
Yeah, so team affiliates, really excited about this new addition for F1 Manager 24. Obviously, in 23, we had reserve drivers as well. This year, we expand that system to include a lot of other drivers across a lot of different ages, a lot of different categories as well. So the way this works, the driver will be assigned to an affiliate in affiliate position in F1 Manager 2024. So the player will be able to sign affiliate drivers to one of those positions. There's 10 slots currently in game planned for each team. So if a player starts with a custom team, as in we've seen from create a team, then they'll have those three slots to fill if they so wish. Obviously, finances will be key for this as well, because obviously each of those new affiliate drivers cost money to maintain. But what that gives you back as a player is an opportunity to develop a young driver, to, you know, work with them, train them to get them where you want them to be when it comes to then take one of the main race seats for the following season. So, really exciting new feature. This is also going to add a lot of new faces and names to the game, which is obviously something we try and do. We always try to, you know, work on authenticity and represent real life as much as possible. And this was a really good way for us to provide that authenticity, so players can now fulfill their fantasy of creating, I don't know, an all-British team of Aston Martin with Hamilton and maybe even Abbey Pulling, let's say, from the Alpine Academy, sign those drivers, have a full British team with staff as well. And that just gives the players a lot of tools to play with. So yeah, really exciting new feature we're adding for F1 Manager 2024. Yeah, so in F1 Manager 2024, the AI teams will have the opportunity to fill their affiliate slots as well and recruit using poaching, which is also something new for this year's game. So the AI teams will have an option to go, there's a few variables going into it, but the two main ones are obviously ability and potential. So if they're really high rated, the team in cause has a lot of money, a lot of resources to put behind their affiliate slots, then they might go for one of the most promising drivers or staff members as well, because this applies for drivers and staff in 24. The other variable is obviously the potential of that driver, so things like age, how good they are already in ability and overall rating, but also, you know, some considerations around mentality, how promising they are, where they are as well. If they're racing in feeder series, for example, they get a little bonus in terms of their development. So all those considerations are part of the AI system, which should be very smart in making those decisions depending on difficulty options as well. And so, yeah, this will apply to the player, but this will obviously also apply for the AI teams. Yes, so with the affiliate driver system that we're implementing for F1 Manager 2024, the players' teams will be able to elect one of those drivers to run in FP1, take one of the main driver seats, and boost the development, which is really interesting dynamic in the game. The AI teams will also use those drivers in FP1 at varied points in the season. This will happen quite frequently, and yeah, the AI teams will also get the benefits from those drivers racing in FP1, getting that experience, those laps under their belt, which is a really interesting dynamic.
Yeah, so Mechanic of Errors is a brand new feature in F1 Manager 2024. And you can develop mechanical failures during the race, and so can your rivals. And you can take advantage of that. So you'll start noticing when sometimes the AI cars suddenly start conserving more and they don't push as much, and this is your chance to overtake them. And then, of course, they can do the same to you as well. But yeah, you can develop variety of different mechanical failures on your powertrain, like being your ERS, your gearbox, or your engine. And yeah, I hope you really like this new feature. So there's a variety of factors that can impact the mechanical failures in F1 Manager 2024. Some of them is temperature, wear, and also running over the curbs. And then you can see how much risk you have. And it's all about risk reward, really. You can see how much risk you have for mechanical failures to develop. And of course, you can keep pushing and then run into the chance of developing mechanical failures, or you can try to conserve and then just to finish the race without any mechanical failures happening. But of course, you won't be able to overtake as much. And towards the end of the race as well, you notice that you have a chance of your powertrain to completely fail, or maybe you can try to push and just to get to the end of a race.
And if that failure is terminal, then that might give players a bit of a flashback. If there's any Hamilton fans, 2016 Malaysia, that's exactly what can happen now in the game. Obviously for the players' teams and the AI teams as well. So again, risk-reward, it can happen to you, it can happen to others, and it really should create dynamic championship standings as well.
So in this brand new feature in F1 Manager 2024, in mechanical failures, you can have different severities of the mechanical failures happen during the race. And of course, you start with being minor and then progressing into a major. So for example, you can have a minor failure on the RS, which will hamper how much energy you can harvest and deploy. Or maybe it will cause your ERS to reboot, which means you can't use your ERS for a short amount of time during the race. The mechanical failures can de-escalate after the race or can escalate during the race. So if you keep pushing, you just run into a greater chance of really having a terminal fault in your engine and retiring from the race. So this mechanic adds, of course, much more choices to your play style during the race sim. And if you have a mechanical failure on your engine, do you decide to keep pushing? Do you decide to keep using this part or buying a new one? And of course, you always run into the chance of having a terminal mechanical failure on your engine, and this will affect your other engine parts as well, and you'll be forced to retire and maybe replace more parts.